Denise and Mr. Eric.
Hello, Lisa. Eric says, hi, Mom. How are you?
Good. I love you.
He says he loves you. He's really holding his heart and really squeezing yours at the same time.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
All right. Well, so a lot of people, you know, we had a conspiracy theory YouTube on a while back, and people loved it. And, you know, I didn't realize there were so many conspiracy theories and mysteries out there. So we're probably going to have to do like a part two, part three, and I don't know, maybe even more than that. So let's just start out. Just short answers, Eric, if you can, because it's like, it's so big. Wow. Okay. So can you please ask Eric about Kurt Cobain and how he died? I would really like to find closure for myself with finding out the truth. So, I, you know, a lot of people think his wife, Courtney, might have had something to do with it. But what happened?
Eric says that he really did. He overdosed is yeah. what he did. Did his wife have anything to do with it? He says him and his wife were doing drugs together very heavily.
Yeah.
But did she actually cause the overdose? Eric says absolutely not. He overdosed. Yes.
Okay. All right. Just curious about any of the Colorado airport conspiracies. I never heard so many of these. Is there a hidden government bunker there? And is the artwork foretelling? Some say the horse statue is cursed. So I don't know anything about this. Eric, do you?
Wow. He says there is a secret place there. Wow.
Was that Denver?
He's showing me Denver, but he's showing me outside of Denver somewhere.
Oh, so maybe one of the secondary airports or something.
Yeah, he said maybe. There definitely is one.
What is it? What is it? What is the artwork foretelling?
He says it's about has to do with ETs.
Ooh! Wow. Yeah. Okay. And is there a government bunker there?
He said yes, but not as big as you think.
Oh.
Yeah, okay. He said yes.
Little cubicle. The horse statue, is it cursed?
Yeah. Eric says only to those that believe that it is. He says no, it isn't. He said no, it isn't.
Also, since I'm currently living there, are there any other beings or entities associated with Yellowstone National Park, specifically Lake Yellowstone?
Eric says that there are, you know, he said, he's showing me from real little beings there.
Hello.
To, larger ones, and he said, to what is that place where that person said?
Lake Yellowstone?
He gives me the impression like they frequent there, they sit around there, their energy is there, but they don't live there, I guess would be what he's given me. Like they frequent there and hang out. They put their energy around there.
Oh, why are they there? Is it for nefarious purposes, good purposes? They're just hanging out. Hey, I want a vacation in Yellowstone.
It is for good purposes because Eric says that the it's almost like that park or whatever isn't maintained as well as it used to be. So, like Eric says, like vegetation purposes of the energy. That they're putting energy in there so it can keep things
the vegetation going?
Eric says as raw as it is, and I guess so there's no more we don't destroy it, I guess is what you know, like do things like that. Yeah.
What about the super volcano there? Is it gonna explode and destroy a lot of America?
Erik says, no, it's not going to do that. No.
Okay. And
when you say explode, I don't feel like that's, I don't get anything like that's going to happen anytime soon.
At least not in our lifetime. Good. Mm-hmm. Did man really land on the moon the first time that they went? A lot of people think it was like, you know, on a set, et cetera, but it really was not true.
Erik is telling me that this was interviewed before, and he said, yes, it was, that they did land on the moon. And he said a previous medium had answered this and had answered it correctly. And he said they did land on the moon, but they were so, as Erik says, they were so damn nervous as to what they were going to, they didn't know what to expect.
Of course not.
And so they were so afraid of what was, of what they might or might not find, that they felt like out of their own fear, they had to protect us. And Erik is saying that, he keeps saying this was answered. He says, Denise, this was answered before, and it's accurate. And he said, okay. Yes. He said, yes, there was a front. But he's telling me there was a front put up, but they actually did land on the moon.
Okay, that's good enough. Mm-hmm. All right. Are the Clintons behind all of those murders, including Vince Foster and Seth Rich?
Who?
If you don't want to, if you don't think we should answer this, Erik, that's cool. Then any of these, if you think it's too dangerous for us to go there, then don't give us the answer, please.
Okay, I'm just a messenger.
Okay.
Erik says that there's not everybody is as innocent as they appear to be. And yeah, he just says everybody's not as innocent as they appear to be. And there's people just know more than what they're saying.
Okay, that's safe enough for us to know. All right, what about Clinton and Benghazi? This one person asks. These are all for blog members, people, so not to the messenger. What role does she have to play in that? What good or what mistakes or what good stuff did she have to deal with that?
See, and I don't know who, I'm assuming they're talking about Hillary, but I don't know who the other person is personally.
Yeah, Clinton and Benghazi, the Libya, Benghazi, Libya.
Okay.
People were killed, including the U.S. ambassador to Libya.
Did Hillary have a direct result, I mean, a direct voice or something to say for all of that that went on? Is, I'm wondering if that, because Erik says it's not as direct as that, but, you know, people have a lot of knowledge.
Yeah, so she didn't cause Benghazi, obviously, but did she make any mistakes? And if so, what were they?
Erik says that, yes, there were mistakes. There were mistakes made. And Erik is just saying she didn't use her voice.
Like all right, so what do you mean, Erik? Can you specify? Because she told everybody it was because of a video. Are you saying that she lied?
Erik said it just wasn't that cut and dry. And nothing can be that cut and dry with something that big, he says. It just can't be. She didn't use her voice prior to anything. And Erik.
Uh-oh.
He says... And she has a big mouth, so she does have a voice to use.
That's funny. But are you saying that she didn't warn about it? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Did she lie about how, you know, what caused it or not?
Erik says she didn't directly lie about it, you know, just come out and say, I have to tell this lie about it.
Oh, yeah.
But Erik, I feel like the way Erik is showing me and telling me, it's like she turned her back to a lot of things, you know, played stupid.
Okay. All right.
To a lot of things.
But this is, I think, the last thing on Hillary. What was in those 30,000 emails that went missing and got bleach bit and all that stuff?
Erik says he's not going to go into detail about those emails because it really serves no good for anybody to know.
Okay.
But he does say that they didn't go missing just because. He gives me the feeling that there's enough stuff in there to where it could put her behind bars, you know, or a regular person behind bars.
Yeah.
Erik is not a political person. He's not pro anything.
Of course not. Not on that side. Yeah. There's no right or wrong. There just is.
Right. Well, yeah. And he just wants people to know this because he says this is a real sensitive subject for both parties. But he said, you know, she knew what she was doing and that she put a lot of information on those emails that she knows that shouldn't have went out.
Okay. Did Peter Strzok and Lisa Page and also other higher up people in the FBI, Justice Department, try to make sure that Trump didn't get elected or that he got impeached?
He gives me to feel like there was roadblocks put in, or they tried to put roadblocks put in.
Okay.
But the way he's shows me how they're trying to put roadblocks in to getting him there. They weren't clever enough, and I feel like the Trump administration was always one step ahead of them, and that really mind-boggled them. Are they trying to get him impeached, or were they trying to get him impeached? Erik says a lot of people talk a lot of shit, yeah. He says. he says some people are looking to try and get him impeached, but there's not enough energy to put behind that.
Okay.
And, yeah.
All right. Let's see. The print is so small on this. Oh, is there a deep state in Washington?
Erik says they mean, is there another department within that, is what he's telling me what this person means. And, he said, of course, there's many layers. There's many layers.
Oh, you know, I bet, yeah.
There's the layer that we're supposed to see. There's another layer that other people are supposed to see. And it just keeps going down. But Erik says, even though the layers are down, the layers are coming up, because he said things are getting to be known. Things are going to are being exposed.
Well, what does the deep state want to achieve?
Control.
Why? Because they think it would be best for us, or some other reason?
Best for them, because there's a lot of fear in that. A lot of fear of, Erik says, of not feeling like they're not in control.
Is it because they want to control the future of our country for the betterment of mankind? Or is it because they want to be in control for their own, you know, being in power and reaping the benefits from the standpoint of wealth and power? Or both. I don't know.
Eric says it's a combination of things as to why they want to do that. It's a combination of things. And he says some of it is fear. He said if they just would take the fear out of that, things would move differently.
Yeah, fear is a bitch. All right, yeah. Here's something that's off of politics, thank God, because you know, mm-hmm. so much backlash about that. But these are not my questions. Is it true that the asteroid belt in our solar system is the remains of a planet that existed in that orbit?
Eric said that it is a part of a planet. Those are chunks of part of a planet. He said, yes, it is.
But not
of a planet like Earth, but he said, yeah, you know.
Okay. Is,
yeah.
Can you describe the planet when it was not in pieces and tell us how it was destroyed?
Eric has shown me erosion, and I'm asking him, was there life on it and stuff like that? And he said, there was life on it, he says, like billions and billions and billions of years ago. And it's almost like the environment is what destroyed it. And it's kind of, he's showing me like the Grand Canyons, how that all of that was caused by water and, you know, and how the water is
kind of hot.
And it's basically kind of like the same thing, you know.
So what split it into all sorts of pieces to make all those asteroids?
He showed me some kind of eruption, some kind of like pressure, like something that just, something just busted it. He's not.
A volcano or earthquake? I mean, whatever. Planet
quake? Eric said, like a planet quake, you know.
Okay.
It's kind of equivalent to an earthquake, but yet it's not the same energy type, yeah.
And I guess the erosion sort of triggered it, maybe? Is that what you're saying, Eric?
Eric is like saying it's like just it's because of like wear and tear. And I'm like, wear and tear. And he says, just life expectancy, you know. Just
Okay. Mm-hmm. Did any of the survivors make it to Earth, or was there Earth even like livable back then?
He said there isn't any life form on it.
Okay, nobody from there that did exist made it to Earth.
Correct.
Oh, okay.
That's correct. Yeah.
And this one person says, to please describe the civilization of Lemuria. First of all, did it even exist, I guess?
I don't even know what that is, Lemuria. Yeah.
It's kind of like Atlantis was a little island, Lemuria, there's others. Way back in the day.
Eric says that these theories don't come about just because somebody decided to start thinking about it.
Yeah, he
said these ideas came. It's almost like he's saying it's someone from the higher ups, you know, people who are willing to hear and receive messages, you know, they get these thoughts, these desires, these ideas about things, and then they start developing, and then that story gets transmuted down to somebody else, and it keeps going on. And he said, like the city of Atlantis, you know, he says, and people know now that that is a true thing.
Mm-hmm.
He said the same is this, you know. He said, yes, it is a real thing. He said, and it's just like mermaids are real, you know, they're just not as pretty as we have.
Oh yeah, because I've seen some pictures of possible mermaids. Okay.
Yeah, and he says like these are real, these things are real, and he says, and that's what people are starting to realize, and they're starting to question a lot of this.
Mm.
And that's why they're starting to find that yes, this is real. And I feel like there are people that channel this city.
Oh.
That city, and they know that this is real, and somehow some of these people who are here now and who species to the human race is like there's a connection there, and they're bringing this forth. And I'm asking them, why is this, like, what's the importance of it? And Eric is saying to get an understanding of what we're doing here with this planet.
Okay. About how long ago was this civilization in existence?
Eric is showing me millions of years before BC, whatever.
Oh, wow.
Whatever BC
cool.
is.
All right, so do you know where it was located? I mean, this guy says, some say it was where Hawaii is today.
I don't get that. Eric doesn't show me that it's where Hawaii is. I don't even get that it was in what we would call as the United States.
Okay.
I don't get that, but...
Was it like the Pacific Ocean, maybe? Ring of Fire area?
Eric's... I don't know what's... And I apologize for not knowing my geography, but it's... Eric is saying that it's... Whatever's next to the Pacific Ocean, it's like borderlining with that somewhere in there, whatever that is. I don't know what that is.
But was it in the Pacific Ocean, Eric?
He said, you know, yes, there, if we don't have the equipment yet, but we'll start locating things there.
Oh, yes. Good.
Yeah.
Is it true that Lemuria was the most spiritually evolved human civilization that has ever existed on Earth?
Eric says, you know, every species wants to think that they're the most highly evolved species.
Oh, that sounds like something Eric would say.
But he says, you know, we're all highly evolved in our own ways. So he says, he said, you know, that would have to go down to a question like, what do you mean more highly evolved?
Okay. Too complicated. It's okay.
Yeah.
Is it true that unicorns existed in Lemuria?
Eric says, yes, in other places as well.
Oh, cool. How was it destroyed? What happened to it?
The first word Eric shows me is greed.
Wow. How did greed destroy a civilization?
He said, you know, Eric says they lost touch with what was really going on. And I'm like, oh, so what do you mean? He says, how they treated the earth is what he's showing me. Somehow how they treated the earth. And just over time, things were just taking care of themselves. He says, but that isn't going to happen over here in this lifetime. And he also is saying that those people there were more in tune with how they can create things than we are.
Oh, like manifesting. Yeah.
Yes, like we don't realize what powerful creators we are. Because we're getting there, and he says he wants people to know that's not going to happen here with the earth in this lifetime or the lifetime after that, you know.
And, okay.
Yeah.
Well, why is it not a land mass that you can see above water?
Eric says because things have risen since then, like the tides have risen.
The oceans, okay.
Yeah, the oceans have risen since then. And okay. I asked him, did it rise because it sunk? And he said, no, just think over time things have risen.
Maybe ice caps, you know, melted, you know, glaciers and stuff have melted. Maybe. I don't know. Are there any artifacts from Lemuria in museums or private collections now?
Eric gives me the feeling that there are some. and I'm asking him where, and I don't get that they're in the U.S.
Okay, so there are some. That's all I care about.
Yeah.
Are there any remaining traces of Atlantis left on Earth? If so, where?
There are some, and that's what keeps the story going and going and going. Because people think and they see things or they hear things and stuff. And Eric says that there are. He says there are. That's all he's telling me, that there are.
What kind of private, what kind of artifacts are like maybe in museums or private collections?
Eric says that there's, I get like some, I want to say it's like dishes because he's telling me like clay or something, like pottery is what he gets.
Okay. Into, okay.
Things like that. I feel like there are, I don't know why, but I feel like there's some body parts or something.
What about any, you know, technological things?
Eric says they haven't discovered any of that yet.
Okay, where, if we were, archaeologists were to look, where would they look? What part of the globe would they begin their search?
Eric is showing me, like, I don't know why he's showing me Peru.
Oh, okay. It's cool.
Somewhere around
maybe
there.
Off the coast of Peru?
Yeah, because Eric's showing me Peru, somewhere around in Peru.
So, Eric, is it off the coast of Peru?
Eric says, yeah, that there are some things off of somewhere in Peru.
Some artifacts?
There's some pieces he's showing me. He's saying there's some pieces there. And of some other places there too, you know.
What?
He's given me, he's also feel like there's some very ancient, like fossils there. Some type of fish.
Oh, wow. So are there artifacts from Atlantis in Peru? Or off the in the waters off of Peru?
Eric is saying off the waters of Peru because he
okay.
That's what he's saying, and I get the feeling like he's trying to protect.
That's where the artifacts are, but that's not where Atlantis, the island of Atlantis, was. Is that what you're saying, Eric?
He said, no, that's not what I'm saying. He's just, from what he's showing me, the city of Atlantis was really big.
Okay.
He's just showing me that there are some pieces off the coast there, and he's not.
Okay, he don't want to divulge anymore. That's fine. Mm-hmm. What is buried on Oak Island? Who buried it and why, and will it ever be recovered? I don't know anything about Oak Island. I've kind of heard that there's something about it, but that's it.
I don't know anything about it either.
Yeah.
From the name, I think there's trees there.
Well, yeah, I would think so.
At what's buried there? Eric says a bunch of lies, but... he wants to know, they want to know what's buried there and will we ever find it?
Mm-hmm.
Eric is not telling me if anything's buried there. And Eric is saying that, there's really nothing of importance buried there. And he says that, I get that there, I feel though that there are some secrets buried there, which Eric says, that's why I said lies.
Okay, what's the lie about? A murder? I mean, he also asked who buried it and why. I mean, why does that legend or conspiracy exist? Is, I guess, what I want to know.
Eric was saying, well, the conspiracy is there because people just know that what was said isn't the truth. So they it just doesn't settle with them. So that's why it just keeps going and going and going until they get settled with it. And I'm asking what is buried there. And again, and Eric just will not answer me.
There's some certain things he just does not want us to know. And obviously is a good reason.
And that's what I keep getting, that he does not, like, there is no value in us knowing this.
Okay, and it could be unsafe, maybe. I don't know. I mean,
What I keep getting, that it's unsafe by the way he says the lies. Okay. Those lies.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. In what nation is the Ark of the Covenant today? And will it ever be found?
What nation?
Boy, they're working on us in geography, aren't they? Ugh, not my strong suit, girl. Oh,
not mine either. When you get out of the United States,
I know,
Canada and Mexico. I feel like when Eric is saying this, I get like over a European area.
Okay.
And will it ever be found? Eric says one day, and I'm asking him like now, and he tells me not in my lifetime.
Okay. Okay. So is it in not in the Middle East, right? Somewhere in Europe.
And when you said that, you know what Eric says, for some reason, I feel like when you said not in the Middle East, I feel like somebody moved it. And that's why it's in Europe. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. All right. Is it true that 3 arcs were made? Dolores Cannon reported that 1 is in a glacier, 1 is in a cave, and 1 is in a private vault. I think we channeled that 3rd one, that it was in a private vault to somebody. I can't remember who.
Eric is saying that's 100% accurate, and he's telling me that's one of the reasons why I'm so attracted, to the Antarctic, because of stuff and everything that's over there. And he's saying that, yes, he says those are accurate. He's showing me that people like us didn't build them, but there was, help. Because
some extraterrestrials, maybe?
He said, yeah, you could go that route, because he says those were massive to build, and without the equipment today, it would be very challenging. So, yes, there was definitely some help, of help.
Did it have, or does it, do these arcs have some sort of special power? Like the, Raiders of the Lost Ark, where, they open it up and everybody melts or whatever. That was kind of a gross scene.
Eric's laughing. He goes, no, Mom, they don't have it like that. He says, but do they have special powers? He said, He said one of their special powers is they're able to survive this length of time.
Oh, what is it? What's in there? Why is it so special? Eric?
He's given me the feeling like those arcs did way more than what we're being told. And he's telling me like the wood, he's saying it's like wood, but it's not like wood that we would find from trees nowadays. And that's really... he said that they have energies about them. Like if people that are sensitive to energies would be able to sense that within it itself.
Of the material from other planets brought by ETs or anything?
Eric said yes.
Wow.
And Eric says that he's telling me it would have to be to withstand this length of time.
Well, what's in it then? One of them, both of them, I mean, all three of them, whatever.
What are the contents in them?
Yeah. At least one, you know.
Eric is showing me like gold.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. Is it true that the Nazis were working with extraterrestrials before and during World War II, Eric?
Eric is telling me, because this is a past life, my recent past life that I visually remember when I was two.
Yeah. Oh, gosh.
And Eric is saying, no, extraterrestrials did not help them do that.
Okay.
He said all of that was a brainwashing and a very sick, distorted mind.
Okay, good. Is it true that the Nazis landed on the moon before the U.S.?
He said, no, it is not true.
And he says, in what year did the Nazis land on Mars? Actually, let's start up with, did they?
Eric's laughing. He said, they did not. The Nazis did not land on Mars. Eric says they were more preoccupied with... Eric says they were more preoccupied with the fucking shit that they were doing here on Earth that they didn't even think about going to Mars.
Oh, yeah. I can imagine.
Yeah.
And it's something that the ego, Hitler's ego, would probably... there was no secret space program then with the Nazis.
No, and Eric is showing me like Hitler's mind was infected. Like he didn't think properly.
Oh, that's interesting, because there is a rumor that he had neurosyphilis, that he got syphilis and it infected his brain. So, wow, that's kind of cool.
Yeah.
So did he have neurosyphilis? Or something else? Dementia, whatever?
Eric said he didn't have that luxury of dementia to claim that.
Okay.
Yeah, I do get like it was something to that effect, yeah.
Okay. Did Hitler really kill himself in the bunker, as we've been told, or did he escape to South America?
Eric said he did not escape to South America.
So he killed himself?
I
guess. Or somebody killed him. What? Did he kill himself?
Eric is telling me he killed himself because he knew he was getting closed in on.
Yeah, yeah.
And he just, Eric says he said we've interviewed him before. He's saying that y'all have interviewed him before, but so there was a role and stuff. But Eric is having me feel that this man was very clever, even though there was like a...
The infection.
Mm-hmm. But he was not going to let anybody take him or do anything. He was paranoid as all ever.
That's what I understand. Is it true that Dr. Mengele from Auschwitz is still alive? That he cheated death through technology? And if so, where is he and what is he doing today? Making little crocheted, you know, pot warmers or something.
Eric is showing me that he is on his side of the fence, so no, he's not still alive. Yeah.
All right. How did Amelia Earhart die, and where is her body?
Eric said that he's telling me she didn't die of a plane crash, like she didn't die on impact.
Oh,
I get like,
ooh, that's what came up. Yes, true. In one interview. Okay. Ooh, cool.
I get like she died from, like she did suffer some severe injuries. I feel like I'm getting like a broken arm and like something to do with her leg. I get the feeling like she more or less died like from starvation, you know.
Yeah.
Hunger.
That's what came out in another interview. It's cool.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yeah.
So I don't know anything about her.
Do you know where? Más o menos. Was it a tiny little atoll or little island? Was it in the, on the coast of some kind? I don't think we ever got that information.
Eric is showing me it's like a real remote area.
Ah, a little island or a landmass or
like an island, like a real remote island. You know,
okay. Do you know what? Can you tell us what ocean? Indian Ocean, Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean.
Was she flying to the Atlantic? Because he's showing me A. So
Atlantic, okay. It's fine. I think so.
Okay, he's showing me an A, Atlantic. And I don't know why he's doing this guessing game with
me.
I think he's playing with me because we did the said stuff about the geography thing. But and I'm asking, will we ever find her remains? He gives me the feeling like we will one day.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. How much power did the Rothschilds really have? And do they control the world? I guess they're talking kind of about the global elite that want to create this new world order.
He says, well, Mom, you know money does a lot here.
Yeah. Love should be the thing that has the most power.
And he says that's what you're creating with what you're doing.
Well, all of us are doing. Yeah. Okay.
He's not answering.
Is it too dangerous? Is that why?
Yeah, I'm like, my chest is...
Oh, okay, we don't do that, okay.
Yeah.
So they're saying, if they have so much power, why didn't they prevent the Holocaust? And, okay.
Didn't benefit them.
What nefarious activities are involved in? I know you're not going to answer that.
Were the who involved?
What are the nefarious activities they are involved in?
Eric says, oh, hell no, we're not answering that.
No, I figured. Oh, my God. Okay, are William Tompkins, Corey Good, Randy Kramer, and other secret space program participants providing accurate information? Is there a secret space program? I don't know. And basically, are they sincere witnesses or are they being used to spread disinformation?
No, Eric said they're not supposed to do that. They're not doing that.
Okay.
No, he said, no, they're not doing that. He's very, very adamant about that.
Okay.
And is there a secret space program or something? He said, of course there's stuff secret within the secret, you know?
Okay.
Yeah, he said, of course. But it's not secret because they're only going to take an Eric. You're so silly.
Oh, of course he is.
Because he says they're not going to only take 444 people. And I feel like that is related to the somewhere in the Bible, that number, because Eric is flipping pages why he's saying that and laughing.
Oh, okay. That's funny.
Yeah.
That's funny.
Because he's saying that because it's not a secret because it's just for the elite or something like that. They're just looking at things.
What do you mean, Eric?
Like ETs, Mom. ETs.
Oh, okay. So they are providing some accurate information?
Yes, he said they are.
Okay. Last question, I think we'll end off because, you know, I think this should be like 45 minutes instead of an hour. Is the cabal, whatever that is, that controls our planet really under assault by positive forces in our military? What is the cabal, Eric? I don't know. Is that a bunch of ETs or something?
Eric is, I don't know what it is either, but Eric is telling me what they're mean. It's like a energy type field, and I'm feeling like people around, so like ETs, and are we doing something to destroy it? He said there's no, we can't do that.
Okay.
But you know, we only know so much and have so much power, but they have whatever that
they
is.
They overshadow us power-wise. Is that what you're saying?
He said, yes. He said, you know, we think we got the power.
Is the cabal bad, or are they the ones that are trying to protect us from the quote unquote bad ETs?
Erik says they're not bad, and he's showing me like white light. They're not bad.
I hear there's some aliens that were under contract that are here to protect us for a certain period of time before the bad ETs come in and get us and the boogeyman survive.
Erik says there is some truth to that, but Erik says, this planet's not going to blow up and we're not going to disintegrate. We're here.
Okay.
He says, yeah, we're here.
Okay. Okay. I think that's good. Let's do that. And we'll probably have a couple more after this. This is part two, actually. Part three and four. And guys, five. You guys need to get in touch with this girl before she is booked up for a decade. Her name is Denise Ramon, and it's deniseramon.com. I will put it here. And Denise, you want to share any last thoughts? Or Erik, do you want to? And thank you, Erik. I know we were treading on some touchy shit.
Yeah, Erik says he's telling me he loves you. He loves you. He really wants me to tell you that.
Yeah.
He's squeezing his heart. He loves you. I have to go look up the cabal and see what that is, because I have no clue what that is.
I don't know what half of this. I know nothing at all about this stuff.
Yeah, I don't either. But Erik
is good.
Erik's telling me to look it up because it's pretty neat. It's pretty neat to learn about that, to read about it. So I'm going to look that up and see what they.
And Oak Island. I want to know what the heck is.
Oh, that's Oak about. Island. Yeah.
Yeah.
Erik says, don't waste my time with that, but I'm going to look at it because he said that.
I know, of course. You're a rebel. Denise the rebel. All right, thank you, Denise.
Thank you.
Love you. Love you, Erik. Love you guys out there. Be sure you go to the archives of the blog, because there's so much there that is not on YouTube, people. Like the interview with, you know, Princess Di and all a bunch of stuff. So check it out, and check out Erik's book, My Life After Death. If you want to know what death is like, crossing over is like, and what your afterlife is going to be like in great detail. Love you.
Love you. Take care.
Bye.